So if you were on Twitter today, you likely saw the hashtag #FireJessAllen. And Jess Allen is a host on The Social. It's sort of like The View, but for Canada. And they talk about all sorts of things that are of general interest, primarily to women, but not exclusively to women. And today they talked about Don Cherry. And Jess Allen made the point that for her, hockey doesn't have this symbolic value. And that the type of man that plays hockey in her life has often been associated with an image of somebody who's not very thoughtful, who can be a bully, who's sort of hyper machismo, and that Don Cherry, you know, who was fired from Hockey Night in Canada, is emblematic of that sort of person. And she said that, and now there's a big backlash against her to have her fired for saying that. And a lot of people are saying that if Don Cherry deserved to be fired for his comments about immigrants and poppies, then Jess Allen should be fired for her comments about white men and hockey. But I don't quite agree. At the end of the day, there are a couple key distinctions. I don't 100% agree with everything Jess Allen said. I'm sure that not every young boy who plays hockey turns out to be a bully, turns out to be inconsiderate, turns out to lack thought. I know that's not the case. I know that's probably not even the majority. But at the end of the day, Jess Allen was speaking about her personal lived experience. Don Cherry, however, on Hockey Night in Canada, didn't say, in my opinion, didn't say, it is my personal view that. Don Cherry made an open statement. Hey, all you people who come here for your milk and honey, all you people who come here for the good life of Canada, you're not doing enough. Don Cherry made a statement, an open statement to non-white immigrant Canadians that they were disloyal. That's what he did. 100%. That's why he was fired. You can try to deny that was Don Cherry's intent, but that's what he said. That's what he meant. That's why he's gone. Jess Allen suggested that in her experience, many of the men she knows in her life who played hockey are not the people she likes, and that she sees similarities between those people and Don Cherry. You might not agree with her. I might not fully agree with her, but those are distinct positions and they have distinct levels of discrimination. And of course, and I know conservatives hate to hear this, but it's true, there's a difference between talking about the predominant white male population of this country on the one hand and marginalized people who are racialized and have new citizenship statuses on the other. There just is. I'm not going to get into social justice 101 in this video, but there's a difference. At the end of the day, that difference does matter. But there's a key factor here that needs to be raised. A lot of people seem to equate this to Don Cherry, seem to equate Jess Allen's comments to Don Cherry's comments. And as I've noted, I don't quite agree. But there's another key factor here, which is that Don Cherry's outburst on Hockey Night in Canada that got him fired, and rightfully so, was not an anomaly. That was not a one-off. Don Cherry has had a long career, and over that long career, he's said many things that have been controversial, that have been hateful, that have been discriminatory, that othered and excluded people based on nationality, based on indigeneity, based on their language, based on where they're from, and on and on and on. This is not the first time Don Cherry did it, and if he kept his job, it wouldn't have been the last. He said some troubling things about immigrants. He said troubling things about foreign hockey players. He said troubling things about French Canadians. He said troubling things about women. He said troubling things about Indigenous people. He said troubling things about Canadians who are environmentalists. He said troubling things about Canadians who didn't support the Iraq War. And these are just the things off the top of my head that I can just list to you right now. And let's say you do believe legitimately that this was a thing that Jess Allen did that is comparable to Cherry. The reality is that if Cherry got dozens and dozens and dozens of mulligans to not be discriminatory and not get fired and continue to be seen as a national media figure, then certainly Jess Allen can get at least one redo on this particular issue. You can't have it both ways. You can't be this free speech warrior who defends Don Cherry and his dozens and dozens of fireable offenses and then turn around the next day or 2 days later, find a relatively young woman who said one thing you disagree with and call for her head. Those are not comparable situations. And of course, given that so many of these people are defenders of free speech from the regressive left, I have to say they look a tad hypocritical calling for a woman to be fired for something similar in their minds that they tried to defend Don Cherry on. And maybe they'll say, well, turnabout's fair play, but why punish Jess Allen for what you feel is a broken and hypocritical system? Why punish her? So a lot of conservatives right now are just trying to call for her head because they want retribution for Don Cherry, even though Don Cherry will gain nothing from Jess Allen being fired. He doesn't want her to be fired. I can almost guarantee that. I can almost guarantee Don Cherry doesn't even know what The Social is. At the end of the day, what she said was based on her personal experience, and she was very clear about that. You can still disagree with her. You can still say that it offends you. You know, you could still have that feeling that she discriminated against people who play hockey and, you know, the young men who play hockey, and that hurts your feelings, and you want her to know that the world of hockey is more complex than she's making it out to be, and she needs to educate herself. That's a position you can have. But that's very different than what Don Cherry said. And while Don Cherry deserved to be fired for his discriminatory remarks, Jess Allen doesn't, especially when you consider how many third and fourth and fifth chances Don Cherry has gotten since his career started in 1980.